Hello student, good morning. I hope you are fine and fit. Today we have discussed about the lesson 5 food, health and hygiene. As you know that in previous online class I have given homework. I hope you all of you learned all homework those are given in previous online class. Today we have discussed about the other factors affecting our health. You know that the nutrients affect our health. They enhance the, they promote the health. But here some other factors, those are affect our health. First number, exercise. Just like food, exercise also very important for us. They make our circulatory system, digestive system healthy and our body fit and fine. Our muscle, they exercise make our muscles strong and healthy. Now next up, rest. After you know that rest is also very important for us, and this means you know that rest is in especially important for brain and nervous system. After rest, then you feel freshness. Okay, and if you take the sound sleep, then you know that after then sound sleep, you feel a freshness. Okay, now next, cleanliness. Cleanliness is a very important for our body. Means time to time cut your nails, brushing teeth regularly. Okay, clean your body regularly, means daily bath. Okay, they make our body healthy. Now next, diseases. You know that diseases are two types. Communicable diseases and second one, non-communicable diseases. First we discuss by one by one all communicable diseases. Communicable diseases, the diseases that can spread from a sick person to a healthy person are called communicable diseases. Example, first number, communicable diseases. Example, cholera, typhoid, chickenpox, smallpox, AIDS, measles, etc. You know that the communicable diseases caused by, you know that term, caused by bacteria, viruses, fungi and you know that protozoa also. Protozoa. Bacteria, virus and fungi and protozoa cause the communicable diseases. You know that the microorganism that cause the disease are called germs. Are called germs, and germs cause the communicable diseases. So you know that first, mosquitoes and fleas are responsible. Yeah, you can say a factor that spread the communicable diseases. Example, okay, fleas. fleas, you know that flea spread, cholera or other type of communicable diseases, mosquitoes spread, malaria, other fevers, those are spreading by the mosquitoes. I give the two examples of bacteria. Those are bacteria caused by the which diseases are caused by the bacteria? Guess? Anybody guess? Cholera and typhoid. Cholera and typhoid are caused by bacteria. Two examples of virus. Those are caused by bacteria. Give the two disease name. Those are caused by the virus. AIDS and chickenpox. AIDS and chickenpox. Next, protozoa, digestive disorder and malaria. Digestive disorder and malaria caused by the protozoa. Now next topic is non-communicable diseases. What do you mean by non-communicable diseases? The diseases that cannot spread, transfer from a sick person to another person are called non-communicable diseases. Example, heart disease, lungs disease, and other those are caused by the bad habit. You know that the heart disease, you know that if you not take the proper amount of, you know that sufficient, you know, not proper amount of diet. If you take the some specific type of diet, means junk food, fats, excess amount of carbohydrates, fats used, then you may suffering from the heart disease. Okay, and lungs disease, if you have the bad habit, means smoking or other bad habits, then you suffer from the lungs disease. So these diseases are not spread from one person to another person. That's why these diseases are called non-communicable diseases. Next topic is prevention of communicable diseases. How to prevent communicable diseases? First number, clean water should be covered, and you know that keep in proper way. Second point, always use the clean water for drinking. Okay, the house should be disinfectant, means when you sweeping and mopping, whenever you mopping, then use the disinfectant, germ kill solution, and you know that the germ kill solution kill the germs, those are found in your house and in room. Okay. On next, time to time, in your surrounding area should be clean and tidy, and in at home as a drainage system also must be have the drainage system. Fourth point, children should be vaccinated against the disease. You know that time to time for children. Your means vaccinated, and you know that the vaccine prevent the all disease those are caused by the bacteria, virus or any other infectious, any other disease or causing agents. Now next, hygiene also important, just like health and hygiene both are related. In hygiene, your good habit include means daily bathing is very important for your body, for your health. clean your nail. If you nail long, then cut and clean. Wash your hand properly. At least your hand, you wash your hand at least 20 seconds. 20 seconds. And you wash your eyes. Eyes are very important for this is a very important sense organs of our body. So wash your eyes regularly at least 3 times. Morning time, and after bathing, then noon time, and then evening time. And this bad habit also make your eyes healthy. And use dustbin. Don't throw any waste material here and there. Use dustbin and you throw this waste material in the dustbin and dispose out of the library food, means out of the where you live, means out of the city.
Now all student write homework. Learn name the following of lesson 5. Learn name the following of lesson 5. And this is your last video before half yearly. So all student, I request you have to learn all exercise from lesson 1 to 5 in proper way. Don't ignore any exercise or any questions. So all student, you have to learn all exercise from lesson 1 to 5. And also you have to complete all work from lesson 1 to 5 in proper way. I will check. Okay, so all student, you have to complete. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you.